If one doesn't release a natural aggression, it will explode eventually in a thought form, out of all proportion, that might cause someone severe harm. And all of this because he was afraid that he's going astray because of aggressive thought of his. And that this thought is more powerful than any vitality that resides within him. Acknowledge the feeling as legitimate, with its own realm of existence. Admit it as a part of yourself. Then choose how you want to deal with it. Do not make others the brunt of your anger. Anger is merely a method of communication. It is important. First, admit that the feelings exist as a part of yourself, at the ego level. Whenever you close your feeling soul from yourself, you are in your own terms less alive. Then verbally communicate these feelings as far as possible. Use anger as a method of communication. Often it will lead to beneficial results. In our perception, strong and violent are connected to destruction. So a strong desire considered to be bad, and a weak desire is good. We become afraid of projecting ideas or desires outward, for in the back of our mind we think that what is powerful is evil. Yet Seth tells us that the universe is a good universe. It is God. It knows its own vitality, and vitality is within you. You can encourage it freely. Your own nature is a good nature, and you can trust it. Because something is difficult doesn't mean it's good. You have always been involved with questions concerning good and evil. You react against things that you still feel some sympathy towards them. While you are freeing yourself, you recognize within your psyche a leaning in that direction that you don't like, and so you lash out whenever you hear such ideas, not realizing that you lash out against your past self, against yourself. All those you know and learn together are interconnected not only within lives, but in between lives as well. When you do not know what to do, just relax and tell yourself that other portions of yourself do know. They will take over. Give yourself some rest. Take life easy. Remind yourself that in many ways you are a very successful person, as you are. Success doesn't necessarily involve great intellect, or great position, or great wealth. It has to do with inner integrity. There's no need to justify your existence. You do not need to write or preach to justify yourself. Being is its own justification. 10 minutes per day, open yourself to your own reality. Realize the miraculous nature of your own identity and life. The room you stand in right now doesn't exist. We pretend to agree that it does. We meet in actually no place of space and time. The true meetings of people have nothing to do with the room or people that we think we are. We know that we are hallucinate the room. We are as much in trance here as we ever are when we're in psychological time. Therefore, you can turn the direction of your consciousness to perceive greater realities that presently exist. You can be aware of your own greater identity, even as Seth is. We sit within the miracle of ourselves, and we're looking for signs from God. But open your inner eyes, you are a miracle. Each decision is done according to the individual understanding. Each of our personalities are free to accept, to develop from the miraculous banks of reality. Those experiences and emotions that we want, and to reject those that we do not want. All you have to do is realize your own freedom. You form the reality that you know. You get exactly what you want to get. You create from nothing the experience that is your own. If you do not like your experience, look within yourself and change it. But realize that you are responsible for your joys and triumphs, and that the energy to create any of these realities comes from the inner self. We are not programmed. Nothing happens because it must happen. Every thought that you have now changes reality. All reality, not only yours now. There are banks of activity from which you can draw and choose not to draw. People choose to die. They choose the time and the method unconsciously. We are but one portion of the huge self, and the fact that you disappear physically doesn't mean that you disappear really. You just change in form of your consciousness. Some situations, for example, a poor disabled woman in Asia, have circumstances that will trigger abilities to help not only the present personality, but other individuals and even society at large. Like a rich man, for example, who tries to be poor for a day to learn what poverty is. He learns little because he remembers that he can go home anytime and wealth is available to him. So, what we do, we hide the reality from ourselves so that we can relate. That's why we think that the physical reality is the only one, so we can forget our home just to come back when we filled our studies, when we achieved what we wanted to achieve. Consciousness is made of exquisite imbalances, and the focus of awareness is the result of this state of excitability. In this state, all elements are never known, because new ones are always being created. You are not now what you were 10 minutes earlier. You are not now the same being physically, psychologically, spiritually, psychically. Open up those barriers that you have erected within yourself. You have infinite energy and strength that are available to each of you. As we utilize those abilities that are ours, heritage, hear your own echo of God's voice as a symbol of your own energy and joy. Forget the cringing self that you sometimes are and remember instead the magic essence of your own being that sings even now through your fingertips. That is the reality which you are seeking. Experience it fully. Travel in peace and joy and safety in your bodies and out. Jane Roberts, 1929 till 1984. Thank you.